for both of us, definitely. Thank you so much.
I you know, when last night, thank you so much, love you too. And last night we were told that we have to come up on stage and talk. We both actually were so busy in working that we didn't get time even to talk to each other, that what do you want to talk, or what do you want to share, or what do you want to, you know, speak to you. And just 10 minutes back, he called me and he said, are you coming? So I thought, I always had this feeling that VCon happens inside the arena. You feel that?
Yes.
But somehow I have a very strong feeling this time, and there's another VCon happening outside the arena, everywhere around also. And we are so busy and so excited doing it. Can you feel that? So first of all, thank you so much, everyone, to be here. Because trust me, it's our privilege to see you all sitting here and making sure that your 5 days of life are going to change your life ahead in future. And you took the decision to be here in VCon. So thank you so much.
I think somewhere for us, 6 years back, it started with a similar experience being a part of a special event called VCon in Indonesia, Jakarta. So you guys are blessed equally to be a part of VCon. And congratulations for having made it and also being excited and survived so far.
So we decided, we were talking to each other that if we have given this platform to stand here and talk, we would like to share and express who we are and what we are and what makes us stand here. Do you want to know that?
Yes.
It's a very simple story. There's nothing much big deal to it. But yes, it's our story. It's our life. It's been our good number of years together. And it's just a coincidence that this year is very special because QNET completes 20 years. Yes. And we complete 15 years of being together. So we have our 15th year anniversary this year in a month's time, actually in a few days' time.
Yeah.
So this year is special, right, guys?
Yeah.
So my name is Shipra. And I come from a very small town back in India, from a place called UP, Uttar Pradesh. And there's a very small city in that state. It's called Jaunpur. And I still remember whenever anybody is going there, I still ask, how are the samosas there? Or how are the sweets there? Because now being staying in Dubai, the only thing I miss is not only the place, the house, but the food, the environment and everything. And I miss it. Because from the time I was born, I stayed in a house for a very long time. I think till the time I was not married. And that house was on a rent. And my parents did their best to give me and my brother the best. And in that small town, because we didn't have proper education system, which was a dream of my parents, they decided to put us to hostels. And we studied in a few of the best schools in India. I studied in Krishnamurti Foundation, completed my 12th, went to graduation in Allahabad University. During the graduation period, I was traveling and I met my better half, Neeraj, in a train. I met him in a train, spoke to my parents, and they said, okay, good guy, good, well studied, why not? And got married at the age of 19. So things happened very, very normal. Is it normal? It's normal. It's very normal. I think that's what my life is all about.
Absolutely filmy. So good morning, I'm Neeraj. From a small town South India called Bengaluru. Namaskara, Bengaluru. Been blessed to have been involved in building a market called Hyderabad. Bagandava, Hyderabad. And of course, the closest, apart from my wife, of course, part of my heart, Nepal. Kusta kuna hunsa. So, for me, I come from a typical low middle class family. My parents, between them, worked for 70 years, hand to mouth fight to bring up my sister, who's older by 2 years, and myself. Very humbling family background, good education, good upbringing, loads of love and affection, but never had enough apart from these, perhaps. So always thought, when I grow up, this is how things are going to be, because that's what I was aware of all through my life as a child and growing up. And I was blessed when I got into an opportunity in my job, one of the jobs which I was working in, called Johnson & Johnson, to go to Lucknow. For the first time, I was really worried going from Bangalore to Lucknow and live there away from my family. Scary. I went to my dad, asked him, should I take this up? He said, Neeraj, Lucknow is into two parts, Lucknow, and there stands my Lucknow.
So that's filmy, not me, okay? And I think from the time we met and we got married 15 years back, because we come from a background where the thought process was to study and then to go get into a job, and we both were working, our life was very simple. Go to office, come back home, go to office, come back home. And over the weekend, have some good time. We got blessed with a beautiful, a very, 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 very lovely and a humble son, Pranay, and we call him with love, Pony. Who is very humble, if I use the word humble, because from the time I've come to Econ, there's not even once I've called him. And every day he messages me, and I can show that on my phone, that every day he messages me and says, what are you doing? I did this. I don't want to disturb you, so I don't want to call you. Take care, serve well, give your best, and have the best in Econ. Every day, every damn day, he messages me and he tells me this. And that's why I say, I'm blessed to have him in my life. And I think he was one of the reasons where I always wanted to do something beautiful for him and really do out of the context something for him. But I never knew about anything. And I think it all started from a very small thought where me and Neeraj were talking, and we were staying in a rented house. We both were working. And we decided suddenly one day to go visit Neeraj's ex-boss house. Right, Neeraj?
Right, new house.
And he took a house and we went there. It was quite far. It was like around 20 kilometers from where we stay. We went there, we saw the house. We fell in love with the house. And we said, we want to buy this. And I told him, can we really buy this house? And he said, as of now, we don't have savings, but let's try. Let's put things together and see. And we together decided to pick that house. And I think from there, our journey started.
It was never easy. I think the first major commitment of after marriage to get into a house was not something which was easy. We went through a deep financial crisis, emotional crisis, almost necked out of the house. Not that my parents were bad, but we made a decision against the parents. And somehow we were struggling. We had to sell our car. I remember selling her jewelry. In India, the Mangalsutra, the chain, wedding chain is supposed to be very auspicious. I had to sell that, ask her to sell it. I had to sell my own wedding ring, chain. So it was very painful emotionally. But then I think somewhere back of the mind, we always thought if you're losing something, maybe there's something greater gain that is waiting for us.
The moment I still remember was the toughest time of my life. that it was 1 month that we really didn't had any cash and we had to pay. And we didn't want to back out from that house because it was our decision together. And I don't know why we were so much. We could have just taken a decision of not buying that house and live normal, but we went ahead. We sold everything and we bought that house. And if I tell you the reason why we bought that house, because that is the house where the neighbor showed us the QNET plan. He showed us, this is you and this can be you. And there in that house in the first year, we got signed up in QNET 7 years back. So all this, whatever happened was only a master plan. And I think from that day, we started believing that even the worst things happen in your life happens for one good reason. And the only thing which we need to do is to wait, have patience, believe in the decision and stick on and keep doing it what you believe. And the results will always be the master plan.
But getting into QNET was a great stress initially, very painful. It was not easy. And obviously I was perhaps one of the main culprits of that. While on one hand I knew that this is something which is going to help change our life for the better, a lot of complications started creeping in. Obviously the kind of person she is, a more aggressive, a more dominant person than me, and she is a person who can hog the limelight and I become her shadow. And that actually was very disturbing for me because somewhere I started feeling insecure that she's moving ahead, I'm behind. And it was doubled up by people around me saying, Shipra, Shipra, and somewhere I felt I'm left behind. And started creating a lot of problems. I don't know how many of you would probably be able to relate to this. I'm sure all of you will, but will be able to accept. I don't know how many of you will accept it. It was absolute crisis. We went through total dirt. Initial part of the journey, the business was very exciting, no doubt. But then, how do we take it forward? As husband, wife, as upline, downline, I wasn't sure. And I was working on this as a husband while she was working on this as an upline, which I also probably should have accepted. But being insecure was creating a lot of problem, not just for me, even for her. And the kind of person she is, she's a person who would definitely take it forward. I knew it. And that's the reason probably why I started this business, to work on this for the family.
I think when I signed up, the first person obviously I spoke was Neeraj. And he said, I don't want to do it, but if you want, you do it. And I said, okay, maybe let me do it because I feel for it. The second person I spoke was my brother. And he said, no. And then I asked Neeraj's help to talk to him and he said, okay, I'll sign up, but I'll not work. I said, okay, no problem. Let's just sign up because I really want to do this. And both the most closest people of my life said no. I could have given up. But I don't know why. I still don't know why. But maybe somewhere deep within, I had this feeling that I want to do something better for my life. And that feel was so strong that I was ready to fight with anything and everything. And things were tough because I was in a job. I used to get up in the morning. I still remember 5:30 in the morning, get myself ready, get my son ready, drive, go drop my son to school, go to my office, stay till late evening in the office and then go to association, work till late night, come home by 11:12. My son used to stay after school with my in-laws. I used to pick him while he was sleeping and I used to drop him in the morning and I used to hardly spend any time with my son. I was hardly spending any time with my husband, which was actually not happening. I was getting tested in my own self every moment, every step, by people saying no, by closed ones saying no, by not having a support. But somewhere deep within, whenever I used to see my son, and whenever I still see my son, I think no challenges stand beyond when I see his face. Nothing stands. And I think that was one reason then, and this is today, that Neeraj standing next to me here on the stage. My brother is serving here in wellness. My best buddy, my best friend who said no to the business, still serving in VCon, also as in service. And that what created, and that what happened, because I believed. Because he believed in my belief and he stood by me after that. We went through very bad times of our relationship because it was not about business. It was about showing us what we are, I think. It showed us how weak we were before this. And I would say QNET helped me, not only building myself financially rich, but it gave me a platform to build our relationship very rich. And I'm blessed. I am blessed to have QNET in my life because it helped me give amazing relationship. And I always use this word, I'm blessed, because I have, I feel, the best people around me. And when you have the best people around me, nobody can stop you from becoming the best. And Neeraj, thank you for believing in me. Thank you.
Thank you. But I think it would be unfair on my part, while there is God up above, thanks so much, my parents. There's one person who helped me survive through the crisis that I was going through. She was my wife. She was not able to understand what I was going through. Me being a husband was not able to understand what I was going through. But there was one person who was able to understand what I was going through and who helped me deal with the crisis was my lifeline associate, V partner, Sharfun Sheikh. She helped me realize my true potential, talking to me, spending a lot of hours, days, and helping me channelize all of those negative energy into some direction which is positive energy. I don't say that today it is non-existent. Even today we have a lot of arguments, a lot of fights. But I think we've understood it's not about us anymore. It's about all of you. And I think it is because of you we are here.
Whatever we are, I think going through all the challenges, going through all the personal challenges, external challenges, together when we stand today and we look forward, in fact, few days back, we were discussing that after reaching to the point which we always imagined 4 years back, saying the word financially free, it sounds very good. It feels very good when you stay in a beautiful house. You have your family getting the best of the best. But what still makes us stand here and serve, what still makes us stand there back home and serve is only one feeling, is that if we can do it, that every person who holds hand can also do it. And if we can way any way help, if we can any way work, if we can any way support, share, even today what we're doing is just sharing and telling that there's no difference between me and you. And if we can do it, so can you.
But yeah, I think we have grown as a couple. We have learned much more through this platform as individuals about ourselves, as a couple about each other. We've understood that probably we need to learn to respect each other. We need to accept each other the way we are. What I learned is that I need to understand she has got amazing strengths while I have some mine as well. So this journey has helped us over a period of time understand each other better, strengthen our relationship, and we complement each other. I know her strengths, she knows my strength. Wherever she feels that she wants me, she takes my help. Wherever I feel I need her, I request her to step in. We complement each other and we understand this is the best way forward. Working together, not as individuals.
But I think if we want to put ourselves together and say something, it would be only this, that it's possible to make anything in life if we want to. If we respect and accept each other, rather than doubt or rather than not having that trust in each other. And what made us today stand together is only one thing, is believing in each other. It's very strongly believe, and I still remember my first VCon when I saw VPTG talking about his family. It made me having more strong that one day we will also stand here together, and this is the first time we're standing together. Because to make that happen, it tested our relationship also a lot. Any external challenge, any internal challenge tested us a lot, but we stood by, and thank you so much, guys, for standing by us. Because if we are standing here, it's because you stood by us. And we promise today that we are not gonna stop. We are not gonna stop. We are not gonna stop giving. We will still show plans on the ground. We'll still do infos. We'll still do invites. We'll still sign up people, and we'll still do every legal and ethical business which is supposed to be done by QNET across the world. And we will stand by. Come what may, we will stand by. And thank you so much. I really want to thank a lot of people. I think it's very unfair of not to name AVP Sachin, AVP Dev, VP Dev. Because whatever we are is because of them. And whatever we are standing is because of all the V partners sitting there. Because you gave us a vision to stand here. Your modules, your every VCon, when you come on stage and when you talk, we get inspired. And even today, I still remember yesterday listening to Dato's session yesterday, that every time we always feel that how he comes up and how he talks every time so different. So thank you so much for giving us all those modules, all those sharings, and all those VCons, always from last 7 years and 20 years from QNET. Thank you so much. And I have something, I really want to tell this. I want to tell this to Nepal team. That one day it's a promise from both of us. That till the time we don't have VCon in Nepal, we will not give up. You will find us always standing with you.
Thank you, VP Dev, for instilling such amazing values into us through this platform called Infinity. It's been an amazing value which you passed on to us. We stand because of a lot of people. I cannot forget the Malik's of the world, the Rais of the world, the Singh's of the world, the Siddiqui's of the world. I don't forget the Mandals of the world. They're unbelievable names. I am here because I believe my wife, my son, who I see every night sleeping with such amazing peace. I think I can do anything forever. And believe me, there used to be a point in time we used to talk that we're not giving enough time to my son. Today, he says, Dad, Mom, give us some space. I think from that to this has been testing, but I think it's worth the pain, because no pain, there's no gain. Personally, for me, I've believed in one philosophy. I don't know how, where, when I got it, but I do believe that if I don't stand for myself, even though the whole world be, I don't think I'd be able to achieve anything ever.
Guys, we don't have anything else to say. But I would want to say from both of our side that we have this beautiful team, and we build it with our value systems taught by our uplines. And from Neeraj to Onil to Apar to Arpit to Brijesh to Yashu to Prashant to Anu, we will stand and we will work and we will give our best. And we stand together because we love each other, and we build with love, and we build, we will always, always, always continue to build.
To last.
To last. and to love and with each other. And we ask you all today to give us that love and give us that commitment and give us that trust that you will also stick on to whoever you are working with, to whoever you're standing with, and you will not give up on your dreams like the way you didn't give, because tomorrow you will be standing on this stage. If you believe, trust me, you will be standing here. 7 years back, we saw this dream and it happened. And I really wish it will happen for all of us. Thank you so much.
This is our story. We are waiting to see a lot of your stories on stage. Thank you.
Thank you so much.